garlicky broiled shrimp. Need I say more? Take it away, Al.
You need not say more. Mm-mm. The only thing you need for this recipe is to have the right shrimp.
That makes sense.
Yeah, you need extra large shrimp, mm-hmm. and that's about 21, 25 count.
Yep.
Okay, so all we have to do is peel and devein these shrimp, mm-hmm. right?
Gorgeous.
I'm gonna take my deveining scissors.
Oh, I love those.
And just cut down the back like so. It's a little bit more work, but I think it's totally worth it.
Agreed.
And I'm gonna take my paring knife and kind of look for the vein. This one's pretty clean, mm-hmm. right?
Nice.
Good to go. So we have 1.5 pounds mm-hmm. of extra large shrimp. I'm leaving the tail on if I didn't mention that.
Oh, I like the tail. It gives you something to hang on to while you eat.
Yeah, you know I love to have a little handle on my food. All right, so we have all of our shrimp peeled and deveined, tail still on. So I'm just adding 1/2 teaspoon of kosher salt. Now, in the test kitchen, we prefer untreated shrimp, mm-hmm. and we suggest that you buy untreated shrimp. But in the event that you have shrimp that is treated, you would skip the salt step altogether.
Makes sense.
Yeah. All right, so I'm just gonna toss the salt into the shrimp and then let it sit for about 15 to 30 minutes.
Okay.
Okay, so now we're gonna make our delicious garlic-based sauce. I'm starting with 4 tablespoons of unsalted butter. And to it, I'm gonna add 1 tablespoon of honey. That really helps for browning. And it's just gonna go in the microwave for 30 to 60 seconds or until the butter's melted, right? I'm gonna cover it with some plastic wrap. It's just to keep all the butter in the bowl, not in your microwave.
Yeah.
All right, I'm just gonna go pop this in the microwave. All right, that was a quick melt.
Mm-hmm.
Take this plastic off. We want it to cool a bit, but not before adding 6 cloves of garlic that I grated in a rasp style grater. All right, all that goes in. 1/2 teaspoon of red pepper flakes.
Oh, a little sweet, a little spicy.
Yeah.
And a lot of garlic.
A lot of garlic.
Oh, you can smell it when the garlic hits that warm butter. It
smells great. All right, so this just needs to cool for about 5 minutes. And in that time, we can start to get all of our equipment ready to cook our shrimp.
Sounds good.
All right. All right, so it's been about 15 minutes mm-hmm. and our shrimp is salted appropriately. And we do need to dry off some of that moisture though.
Yeah, you can see how glossy they got. A lot of moisture did come out of the shrimp.
So I'm simply just gonna put these on a paper towel lined plate, mm-hmm. right? And try to lay them out as flat as possible so that they all can get dried, right? All right, so I'm gonna use a paper towel just to absorb some of that moisture. So I'm gonna put it back in the bowl. All right, and so I'm gonna pour our garlicky butter sauce on top of the shrimp. Yeah, this is when the fun starts. This recipe actually starts to go really fast from here, so it's best to have like all of your equipment set up and ready to go. So I'm tossing the shrimp in the sauce. It's very, very important that each shrimp gets covered.
Okay.
Were you savoring the moment?
Yeah, savor it smells the flavor. Delicious.
Yeah.
This is my kind of shrimp right here.
Yeah, this is next level. Okay, so now it's time to get our shrimp in the oven. I have here a foil lined sheet tray with mm-hmm. a wire rack on top. Mm-hmm. And we're just gonna line these shrimp on here with a little bit of space in between. They don't need too much.
The foil's just for easy cleanup, I'm guessing.
That's right. I love how the garlic is sticking to the shrimp. Mm-hmm. It just lets me know that I'm in for a flavor party and everyone's invited. So I'm just gonna continue to line them up, a little space in between. All right, so these are ready to go into the oven. I have my oven set to broil. I have the rack set about 4 inches from the broiler element.
Ooh, that's nice and close.
Yeah, yeah, and they're only gonna go in for about 3 to 5 minutes.
Mm, okay.
All right, so let's go.
Take our recipes and reviews wherever you go with the America's Test Kitchen mobile app.
Fail-proof recipes, unbiased equipment reviews, how-to videos, and a vibrant community of like-minded home cooks.
With smart searching and handy tools, you'll have everything you need to create the most amazing meals.
Download the America's Test Kitchen mobile app today.
Whoa.
That looks so amazing.
That looks fantastic.
They are nice and pinkish still. They're plump and lightly charred. They're ready to go.
All right.
Now, if you were serving this as an appetizer, you could serve up to 6 people. But if you were serving it for dinner, it serves about 4 or,
or two.
Yep.
Oh, the smell is amazing.
All right.
Let's eat.
It's bountiful. All right, so I'm just gonna hit it with a little lemon. Splash. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my mouth is watering.
Friends first.
Thank you.
I can't wait to eat these.
All right, going in.
Oh, so good.
Mm-hmm. The shrimp are perfectly cooked. They're cooked through, but they're still juicy. They're not rubbery.
Yeah.
And the flavor, you get garlic first, and then a blast of heat, and then you have that soothing honey finish.
This is great, but you can get other variations of this recipe on our website.
Oh, these are fantastic.
Thank you.
So if you want to make these incredibly easy and garlicky shrimp, start by tossing the shrimp with salt and letting them sit for 15 to 30 minutes. Coat the shrimp in a garlic and honey butter and broil them for 3 to 5 minutes. From America's Test Kitchen, the final word on garlicky broiled shrimp. You can get this recipe and all the recipes from this season, along with select episodes and product reviews, on our website, americastestkitchen.com/TV. Surf 6. We hope you enjoyed this video as much as we enjoyed making it.
Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel.
And if you're ready to take your cooking to the next level, head over to americastestkitchen.com and get a free all-access trial membership.
While you're there, you can sign up for our free email newsletters and download our app.
With unlimited access to over 14,000 of our test kitchen recipes and 8,000 product reviews, you'll have everything you need to cook and learn.
So I ask, what are you waiting for?
Let's make something great together.